Hey guys, Aleksey from Ace 5 Studios, and today I'm gonna teach you about how to animate characters in Cinema 4D. This is not a theory course, it's not gonna teach you about the theories of animation, this is just the technical stuff, how to move things around, how to pair and stuff, how the rig works. The reason I do this is because I realize that I sell a bunch of character rigs, and I don't have any videos showing people how to actually use them. And once you finish this tutorial, or these series of tutorials, I guess, that I'll make, you'll be able to follow character animation tutorials made by very talented people for other software like Maya and 3D Max. And that's really the main goal of this, because I'm by no stretch of the imagination a professional character animator, but I do know how to use them and how to animate them. So that's what I'm going to teach you. So let's get into it. Okay, let's get started. So you open your file with the Johns, and let's say I want this guy to animate him. Now, if I select, just click on him right now, you'll see that it doesn't actually select, for example, the head controller here, it just selects the mesh. So what you want to do is once you click something, you'll see which null it is and click on this null. So you select everything inside and then go to Control C, go to your scene where you want to animate him and press Control V. Now you'll see that, for example, in this scene, the character is very small and your first instinct will be to scale the character up, and you might go to Google and type in how to scale rigged characters, because if you just scale him, you'll see it doesn't quite work as you'd expect. And I actually even have a tutorial on how to scale rigged characters. But I would advise you, if at all possible, not to scale the rigged characters. Whenever you can, scale everything else around the rigged character. You'll see if you click on this mesh here, you'll see that his height in the Y is actually 188 centimeters, which is the regular height. It's like 6 feet for a human. And ideally when you work, you want to scale all your stuff to be realistic in size. So right now this table is nearly 2 meters high, which is not realistic. So what you want to do is you want to grab all your other stuff and scale it. But the thing is that when you scale it like this, you'll see that it's not on the ground anymore, and it moved somewhere and not very convenient. So let's undo that. What I would do is I would make a null object, and I would place this object where I want to scale it. So for example, if you want to scale it around the chair, so if the chair is in the right place, move the null object to where the chair is. So there you go, it's underneath the chair. And then drag everything except the John character, so all the lamps and tables and whatnot, and put it into this new null that you made. And then just scale the null. And I think that's about the right size. Let's move it a bit closer here. No, definitely smaller. I think it should be about waist height, maybe even smaller. Seems about right, or maybe a bit bigger. Who knows? Seems about right. Anyway, let's hide these plants because we don't need them. By the way, if you notice, I clicked on both of these at the same time. You do that by holding Alt and clicking on to hide them. Then you're turning both editor and render visibility off. So let's get our chair selected. Don't forget to select the full null. Let's rotate this guy, place him where we're going to want our character to sit. So somewhere here, rotate a bit more. Seems about right. Now, so let's get our character to sit. That's basically, we're going to work on a simple animation here, which is going to make the character sit. Now, the first thing you might think is, well, okay, I'll get this controller, right? And I'll move him over here and then I'll rotate him. But the thing is, I wouldn't recommend going straight for this, because what I would do first is I would move the main null. Now, the reason is because there's this function here called all my rigs have this reset PSR function. So if I press this button up here called Reset PSR, if you don't see it, you can go Shift C and find Reset PSR. I really recommend tying this to a shortcut. I have it on tilde X, and you click it, you'll reset the controller back to where it was. So if any of your controllers are in the weird place or somewhere like this, you can just press Reset PSR and it's back in its default position. So it's very handy when you're animating sometimes. You're like, oh, what's going on? And you want to just put it back to where it was. So you should move this main null to the location where you want the general, you know, reset position. So where you most likely, so in this animation, he's just going to be sitting and standing next to the chair. So let's just move him and put him in next to this chair, like the whole null. So this is approximately where he will be. And this is a solid position for him for the default place. Now, so let's get our hips here and let's keyframe on frame zero. So we put this keyframe here. And let's say it'll take you 15 frames to sit down, go to move tool, and drag him into the chair. Let's say here and put a keyframe. Now, right now I'm feeling like maybe everything needs to be smaller. So let's get our null of our whole scene. Let's call this scene. And let's scale it down a bit more. I feel like this is a more realistic size for. Yeah, that seems better. Even smaller. Skinny guy, huh? Anyway, I think this is about right. Maybe too small. Very good. Scale is very important. Don't worry about playing with it a lot. You can actually measure stuff and make it the right size, but tweaking scale is a very common thing. So right now we have him sitting down. Let's make him. Sure, we're in frame 15 and sit him down a bit more here. Seems about right. And keyframe. Also, the F8 on your keyboard will set the keyframe. So that's a quick way of setting keyframes. If you roll over, you can see, oh, F9, sorry. You can see here in the bottom, F9 will set a shortcut. F8 will actually, I think, play. Yeah. So we got a keyframe, we got him moving. Now, the thing you'll notice is right now, while this is fine, the hands stay over there. So you have to move them and keyframe them in the new position. And sometimes this is okay. Like right now, if you notice, let's reset the PSR here. If you notice, when you move the body, the hands kind of try to stick to where they are. And this can be useful. For example, let's move this body down here and let's move this hand down onto the table. So if the hand is on the table and he's doing push-ups or leaning, this is useful. You want that hand to be stuck there. But let's go reset PSR on this one. In this animation, we generally want the hands to follow the body. We don't want them to be independent. So what you want to do is you want to select both these controllers. Like you can have a look where they are here. So these two, these left and right hand con goals. And there's this command called set parent. So let's press Shift C and set parent. And we want to set parent here to our hips. So basically, anywhere our hips move, the hands go with it. But notice if our chest moves, the hands are still stuck with the hips. You'll see in a bit why this is important. Something you have to think about before you start an animation. There are ways to modify what the hands are attached to, but generally it's a good idea, I think. Like generally I prefer to keep my animations short. Like I try to break them up into shots. So I try to have separate files for each kind of movement that I have. So if he's sitting down, that's one file. When he's walking away, that's a different file. When he's looking at the computer, that might be a third file. So in this file, we're just getting him to sit down. So we basically want him to be stuck with a waist. So, oops. So he animates down. And we want these hands, I think on frame zero, we want the hands to be down by the waist. So somewhere here, and we can rotate them. And maybe rotate them like this, and oops. I think it's a good place for the hand. So let's keyframe it here. So with this button, let's move this thing down along as well, and rotate it over, and move it by the waist. Make sure the hand isn't straight out because that looks kind of unnatural. You probably want to, have it like somewhere like here and keyframe it. Rotate it so it kind of follows the hand. Maybe there you go. Something like this. And now when he sits down, it's a bit more natural since the hands aren't sticking out. I want these hands to be somewhere on his lap. So on frame 15, let's rotate these guys. And let's move them here forward. Now you'll see that they don't actually reach. That's because our character needs to lean over before they're here. So let's keyframe it somewhere here. And now let's select this controller here and rotate it so that he leans forward. See, and then the hand kind of lands there. And let's put a keyframe here. Now, if we scroll back to zero, we'll see this is out, but he's still slouching over. So you could just manually fix this and make him stand up on the first frame and keyframe. Or you could just hit the reset PSR button. Then he'll be in the default position and add a keyframe. So this is useful. So now he slouches forward to sit down and he moves his hand on his lap. And you might want to also animate this guy. So it's on zero. Let's put a keyframe. And then on 15, we're going to slouch forward a bit. Now, as you can see, and the reason we have this hand attached to the waist is because now when we move this, see the hand is stuck to his legs. So that's why we have this parented to the waist. If we had it parented to the chest, then when the chest moves, the hand would move. Not very convenient in this specific scene. So he sits down. As you can see here also, he kind of, actually here it's okay, but if you don't like the way the hand is moving, for example, let's say this guy, let's say we don't want it to move straight to the lap. Let's say we want it first to stay by his waist a bit longer. So let's drag this up to like frame 7 here. As he sits down, and then it starts moving only later on. But now it's intersecting with this lap. So what we can do is just on this frame where it's intersecting, we can just move it up, maybe rotate it so it's not intersecting. And maybe here we can rotate it out here so that. There you go. And just keep on adjusting it and adding keyframes until. See, then he sits down and is here. You might also want to move this elbow controller. So let's go to frame 0 and keyframe its original position. And then on frame 15, you might want it to be out here somewhere. So there you go. So he sits down. And the next step is also the head is kind of looking down. We want the head to look forward. So it's on frame 0. Let's keyframe it here. And on frame 15, let's just rotate it up and keyframe it. And now we have him sitting down, kind of slouching and looking up. We can also make the head look up later because maybe at the beginning we want him to look down with a slouch. So let's drag also his keyframe up to like 10. So now at the beginning he bends down, then he sits down and looks up. And you can adjust this, you can drag it a bit back so you can see. There you go, and then he looks up. And the same thing with this hand. We can also keyframe it from here, and we can just. Maybe we have it just landing on the chair here. And keyframe it. And see here right now, we have this kind of happening on frame 20 because we accidentally were in the wrong place. So you can just click and drag this to 15, and now it'll move together with everything else. We rotate it so it's not intersecting the chair so much. Or maybe just drag it down a bit. There you go. So now you have this kind of guy just sitting down. Maybe also make his initial pose a bit more natural. Maybe let's get our foot here and maybe rotate it out a bit and move it across. And keyframe it there. So when he sits down, it's. And then also, we have to adjust this guy now to the final resting position. So maybe here. And maybe we want to delete some of these frames because it's too many of them. If you can't click on it, you might have to deselect by clicking on an empty place and then clicking on the keyframe. So this is almost correct. We just have this rotation here, so. There you go, we have him sitting down. And that's pretty much it. That's the basics of animating here. And obviously you can, so he sits down and then you can rotate his head so he looks at the computer and keyframe it there on frame 20. What I would recommend is also when you animate, you might want to give a pause. So for example, here I want to let's make him look at the computer on frame 30. So let's go back to 0 and play this. But also let's have him hold the head at 15 for a while. So we get this frame and we just control drag it to 20, maybe 25. So he sits down, and then he turns. Maybe 25 is too long, maybe 20. Sit down and there you go. So this is how you make a simple animation. Hey guys, hope you enjoyed that video. And make sure to check out my website for rigs and free rigs and paid rigs and tutorials and all kinds of stuff. In my next kind of videos, I think I'm going to be going over more information on how to render a production with characters, how to, do storyboards and previs and stuff like that. If you're interested in that, make sure to leave a comment below. And don't forget to subscribe to me on Twitter and Instagram. I have these short form 1 minute tutorials which people seem to really like. Until next time.